In this video, you're going to learn how to use Databutton to build a functional CRM that integrates with HubSpot to automatically fetch contacts from your HubSpot CRM. Databutton now integrates with Google Gemini 2.5 Pro, which as of the recording of this video, in my opinion, is the best AI coding model available. Thank you so much to Databutton for sponsoring this video. Be sure to click the link in the description to go to Databutton and build your very own app like this. Let's get into it. Go into your Databutton dashboard. We're going to click New App, and then I'm going to type out the prompt for this app. So the initial prompt is going to be a simple CRM that connects to HubSpot to import contacts. So we'll click Continue. I'm going to go ahead and skip the optional requirements, and we'll let Databutton use its defaults for the requirements and for the design inspiration. For integrations, we're going to use Firebase. For database, we're going to use Firebase. And I'm not going to worry about payments right now. For storage, we can use Firebase storage as well. Firebase, Firestore, Firebase, auth is all natively integrated into Databutton. So if you're using Databutton, I do recommend using Firebase, and you'll see how easy it is to integrate here with Firebase and Databutton. So I'm going to pause the video while Databutton creates the initial version of our app. So here, Databutton has created basically 8 different tasks to build our app. It's named the App Connect Hub, which I like. And the first thing we can do is just have it start this task for the first task to set up the landing page with branding and an overview. So pretty quickly, Databutton created a basic landing page here. And one thing I'll note is that it seems like Databutton is getting faster at building out these features. So we'll see how it continues throughout the rest of the app, but I'm really impressed by how quickly it built this out. Now, of course, it's very simple, but I think it's great for a starting point. So I'm going to go ahead and mark this as done because this task is done for step one. We'll go back to the plan, and then we will start on step two, which is configuring Firebase extension for authentication. So I'll go ahead and click that, and I'll pause the video while Databutton starts working. So adding Firebase, Databutton makes this really easy on the chat. It just adds a little button here to add Firebase, and then it gives us specific instructions on how to do this. So here I am in the Firebase console. I'm just going to click Create a Firebase Project. I'm going to name it Connect Hub CRM and continue. And we'll go ahead and continue. Well, we can turn off Google Analytics for this a test project. We could always turn it back on later. I'll pause the video. Then we'll go ahead and click on authentication in the dashboard here. If we go back to Databutton, I should just be able to click authentication settings, and then hopefully we'll have to go back into the Connect Hub, then just click get started under authentication. Then Databutton gives me some instructions here. They recommend enabling email and Google sign-in, so I can go back and do that. We'll do email, and we'll enable that and save. And right now, that's all I'm going to do. We could do Google sign-in as well, and it would just be as easy as clicking add new provider and selecting, but let's keep it really simple and just do email password for right now. And then if I go back, so I did that, then I need to add this domain, so I'm going to copy it, databutton.com, to authorize domains. So we'll click that. I can actually just go back to our project itself. We'll go back to the project overview. And then to do that, we just have to go back to authentication, so right where we were. And then on the top, we'll go to settings. And then we'll scroll down to authorize domains. And this is where we need to add a domain, which was https://databutton.com. So I'm going to add that authorized domain. We'll go back to Databutton, and I will check that off and click install Firebase, auth, and valid config. One more thing. I need to go to the Firebase console under Firebase set project settings and get that config. So we'll go back to our project and just go ahead and click that little gear on the top left. Go to project settings. Then under your apps, just go ahead and click this gear, which is for a web app. So I'm going to name this Databutton web app. For now, we'll just register the app. And then let's just continue to console here. And then here, we can go to config and get our Firebase config for our app. So just a little bit of setup there, but not too difficult. And then we have our config, which we can then paste right there and then click install Firebase auth. So now Databutton is going to go through this process. I'm going to pause the video while it builds this out. Okay, so right like that, now it says our app is protected and we have Firebase authentication so users can sign in and safely and securely. So I'm going to click done, and I believe it should be all set then. So let's see what it says. The extension should add some authentication, login, logout. So now it's going to just update the UI on the app itself to have the correct login and logout functionality. So it wants me to test the authentication flow now. So I'll click sign up, and it says sign in with Google. So I'm going to say, instead of sign in with Google, use email password authentication, because that's all I set up so far. So it probably just assumed that we turn on a Google authentication, but right now we actually only have email and login. So I'm going to ask it to update that. So it says that it should only add what is available. I can try it and see what happens. Yeah, so I'm going to say, because I didn't enable it, which I could go and enable it, but I just would like it to work the way we asked it to. So I'm just going to say, this is what I see. Please ensure email password is available. I'll pause the video. Now, I guess I could just go back to our app real quick under authentication. We'll go to sign in method. So it should have email password enabled. Let me just turn Google on. We'll enable it. And then let's click save. So now they both should be enabled. I don't know why it's not including the email login, but let's see if that solves it. So now it looks like, great, I can actually log in and continue. And cool. So I should be logged in now. So I'm going to say I logged in. Can we update the nav bar to let the user see they are logged in? So hopefully that worked. I'll pause the video. Okay, great. And now we can see we have our email at the top just to let the user know that they are logged in. So that's great. I'm going to go check this as done. And now if we go back to the plan, we can see we can start to implement more features here, create dashboard layout with navigation and user profile section. So let's start this task, and I'll pause the video as it builds this out. Okay, so it says it made it. So let's see. We'll go to the dashboard here on the left side, and we can see if it works. We can click on, it doesn't seem like the contacts page, but it kind of set up this initial dashboard. So I think that's fine for now because we're going to continue adding actual data moving forward. So I'm going to mark this as done, and then let's go ahead and start on task 4. Okay, so Databutton is giving us information here about how to set up in Firestore. So we're going to go back to our CRM here. We're going to go to Project Overview. We're going to click on Firestore here to set that up. We'll go ahead and click Create Database, and we will continue. We'll start in test mode. We'll click Create here. Okay, and now I need to go ahead and copy the security rules snippet here, which I just copied. We're going to go back to our Cloud Firestore, and we don't have to set anything up here for collections or anything right now. We'll go to rules, and I'm just going to paste in our own security rules and publish that. And then I'm going to go back to Databutton, and I'll say I just updated the security rules. Okay, so it says that's all we needed to do, so I'm going to mark that as done. And now we're going to go to the next one, number 5, and start this task. We're making some pretty good progress here. And I'm really excited for you to see what this turns out with in the end, especially once we connect HubSpot. So make sure you stick around as we continue building out these tasks. Okay, so it looks like this task was successful. It added this contacts page. One thing I just want to note that what I did was at first it looked like this with this error. So what I did and what I recommend you doing if you run into errors, screenshot the error and ask if it's okay or what the issue is, and Databutton solved that for us, which is great. So let's go ahead and mark this task as complete. We're going to go back to the plan here. And next is creating contact detail view with edit functionality. So we're going to start that task. So we're getting really close to that HubSpot API integration, which I'm really excited to show you. Okay, so this looks good to me. Basically, we don't have any contacts yet. So it's not going to work to actually like see the details of it. But I think that that's fine. And we can always modify it later once we have our contacts and we see if it actually works or doesn't work. So I'm going to go back to the plan here. So next is developing the HubSpot API integration for importing contacts. So let's go ahead and start that task. And I'll pause the video as it works on that. So what's cool here, I just want to point out, is that Databutton is researching how to interact with the HubSpot API. So this is really cool that it is able to do the research for you. So you don't have to go and copy the API documentation and give it to Databutton. It just is going to do that research on its own. But here it's telling me, I need to go into my HubSpot account and add the correct token. So here I am in HubSpot, and you just have to go to your settings on the top, go to private apps. We're going to create a private app here, and we can just go ahead and give it the basic information. So I'll say Databutton connection. Great. And I'll have to upload a logo here. Then we're going to go over to scopes on the top. We're going to add a new scope. And Databutton told us what we needed to add. So I'm going to go back to Databutton real quick. And it's asking us specifically for the CRM objects.contacts.read. So we'll go back CRM.objects.contacts.read. So we just need to be able to read our contacts. So I'm going to click update. And I think that is everything that we need. So it's just that one scope that we need to add for now. And then we're going to create an app. We're going to continue creating. And then here, we need this token. I'm going to show the token, copy it, go back to Databutton. And what we're going to do is here, it's asking us here, which is really cool. Also, the Databutton does this, is it's giving us a secure way to put our token in. So I'm going to paste that in and hit send. And now Databutton is continuing to build out our connection. Okay, so now it wants us to test this out. So we can go to the preview, we can go to the import page, and we'll click fetch contacts from HubSpot. And okay, this is pretty amazing. So these are the two contacts that were in our HubSpot, and I'll show you real quick. So if we go to HubSpot and we go back to our CRM contacts. These are the two contacts that were in our HubSpot just automatically when we created our account. But if you had as many contacts as you had, it would be there. So here, let's go ahead and check both of them. Click import selected. And let's see if the importing actually works. Okay, so I'm going to take a screenshot actually, just so I can share this with the chat. And I'm going to say the app shows my contacts from HubSpot, but when I click import, nothing seems to happen, and I'm going to go ahead and click send. So I'll pause the video while Databutton debugs this. So it's asking me about the rules that I set, so I'm going to just copy this and go back to Databutton. I'm going to say this is the current rules in Firestore, and I'm going to send that. So let me see if that gives it more context on what's happening. Okay, so it wants me to test this again. I'm going to click import, and I'm saying I'm clicking import, but there is no pop-up notification. And I looked at my developer console, and I also didn't see any error in the console. So let's see what happens there. Okay, so I see the error here. It says the user isn't logged in. So I'm going to copy this, and I'm going to say, here's the error, even though I am logged in. So let's see if that solves it. Right, so we'll test it one more time. It says that it fixed it. And I can see here the Firestore batch committed successfully down on the bottom in the terminal. So let's go to contacts. And perfect. So now I can see the contacts were successfully added. So great. I'm going to go ahead and mark this as done. And then now we can go on to the last step and start this task of building import UI with HubSpot connection status indicators. So we'll go ahead. I'll mark the previous one as done here in the chat, and I'll pause the video while Databutton builds out this task. I just want to point out how well Databutton reasons when it writes this code. So it'll tell you what it's doing, kind of reason out, make a plan, write the code. If there's any issues, it notices it and makes changes. So I really like the way that Databutton kind of reads the code that it writes and then tries to kind of continuously modify it until it works. All right, cool. So here we can see that now we have this badge that says our HubSpot is connected. If we fetch contacts here, it'll show up. We can import. I wonder if it just added. So yeah, so now I guess it added multiple contacts, which isn't ideal. But overall, it's working, which is cool. So if we go to import, and we could always modify that to basically not allow you to upload duplicate contacts. So one more thing I'm just going to debug. So if I click into a contact, I'm getting permission denied. So I'm going to ask it to fix this. So I'm going to say, I'll pause the video while I do this. So basically just saying, if I click into a contact, it says permission denied, even though I should have access, and asking it to fix that. So I'm going to pause the video while it does that. Okay, cool. So let's test this out. Now, if I click in, yes, I can view the contact details. I can click edit, and let's just update the first name and see if that correctly updates it back to contacts. Correct. So yeah, so now I can update all of these contacts as well, which is pretty cool. So now what I'm going to do is ask it to build basic CRM functionality for a sales funnel in a Trello-like board, because I want to actually be able to do something with these contacts. And the point of this is not that you would necessarily need to do this if these contacts are in HubSpot already, but I want to show that you can do something with this data in Databutton, and you can build really anything you want customized for your specific use case. So what happens is Databutton will create basically an implementation plan for this. So I'm going to go ahead and create the tasks. And it created four new tasks in our plan for this, which should get added soon, I believe. So we'll go ahead and click Create Task. Okay, so let's see the progress here. If we go to Sales Funnel, it looks like it's built the board, and we can't drag and drop between columns though. So I'm going to say, I see the board, but I can't drag and drop between columns. Okay, I'll pause the video there. Okay, so it looks like it's working correctly now, where I can drag the leads through different stages on this funnel. And of course, we could build a lot more into this with Databutton, literally anything we want. But I'm going to stop now. And if you followed all along, we've built an app using Databutton that connects to Firebase and Firestore for authentication and storage. We have the ability to connect to our HubSpot CRM and import leads from HubSpot directly into our app that we built here, which is really, really cool. So we can quickly see what the users are and import them into our app. And then we also built some basic CRM functionality into this CRM to build a sales funnel. I definitely recommend going to Databutton yourself. Click the link in the description to build an app like this on your own. And you can build literally any idea that you can think of and just ask Databutton to help you build it. If you have any questions at all, leave a comment below. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more free content like this right here. And go to nocode.mba if you want to learn more about building with AI and no-code tools from start to finish. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.